Hey guys, welcome back to my project. I'm Eric here. Today, I'd like to introduce the library I distributed. This library makes your display show the digital rain animation that was shown in the movie Matrix. The reason I made this library was that I was preparing a Flutter application that worked with ESP32 TTGO, and I wanted to have this text animation as an effect. On the left screen, as I shown you in the previous video, it's animating using split JPEG images. On the other hand, on the right screen, this is a code-based text animation effect. There are definitely pros and cons to these two. For spectacular effects, I recommend using images, and for performance and various settings, I recommend using code bases. Okay, let me show you how to use it and the result. Let's dive into the matrix. This project is based on TFT API, so please set your display correctly first. If not, it's not working. If you are using the ESP32 TTGO T-Display model, please refer to the previous video. It's good for you. The first thing to do is to install the library. I created the library called Digital Rain Animation for TFT API for this project. Let's go to the library manager and let's see it's available. I think my library is still under review, since lots of libraries require to put it in, so it takes time. Anyway, let me open my library GitHub within a web browser. The link is in the description below. I will download and install it directly from my GitHub repository. After download it, install from Arduino IDE. Simply select the downloaded zip file from the sketch, include the library, add the zip library. It says library added to your libraries. All looks good. Go to examples, digital rain animation for TFT API, select the demo. Here you are. It's a very simple example. There is nothing special to do because it was created with the basic functions of TFT API. Let's build and check the result. Okay, it's showing well, right? This text animation is all from a couple of for loops and random functions. It can easily calculate how many lines it can have from the width of the screen, and then add random length and speed to each line. The data for each line is dynamically handled using vector in C++ STL in the initialization part. Lastly, the first character of each line is displayed in white, and then the color value is adjusted using map to start with dark green and gradually blur. If you look at my code, you can easily understand it. Let's try to play the next example. The second example is including two button sections. I made this function because I'm currently using the ESP32 TTGO T-Display model. This example also shows an initialization function that allows you to adjust the minimum maximum speed and minimum maximum length, and finally the value of the interval in which the animation runs. This initializing function is more effective and allows you to implement the text animation you want. The button2 library is used to use the built-in buttons. Please install this library if you need it. Okay, let me try this one. It is different from the first animation because the default settings have changed. If I press the right button, the animation stops, and if I press the left button again, the animation resumes. One thing I want to tell you is that the button action doesn't work sometimes. It would be better to use a wrong click event rather than just a click event. Let's talk about the text on the screen. When I'm making this, I thought about what would be good to print out. I thought using Unicode would be better to be more interesting, but I decided to use the most simple way, ASCII code. The ASCII chart from 33 to 126 contains numbers, uppercase, lowercase letters, and symbols. I thought that's enough for now. This is how I got the string value from the ASCII character to show on the screen. Lastly, I will change the orientation of the screen. Simply select the desired display direction in set rotation of TFT ESPi. For your information, 0 and 2 are in portrait mode and 1 and 3 are in renderscape mode. All done. Build and check it again. This library works normally on color displays that support TFT SPI, because it was created with a few functions provided by TFT SPI. One thing you need to know is that if you have an animation interval too fast, the animation effect may look weird. My next plan is to make some interesting mobile app connected with ESP32 TTGO. Let's see how it's going. Okay, thanks for watching. See you in the next project.